Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 18 of my Resident Rise Let's Play. And today, for the first part, I want to continue doing on some more totemic stuff. Currently, Pookfan isn't online, sorry for that. I also did some testing in a single player world and found out some very cool stuff with totemic. Pretty much how to use most of the, these thingies and code only item. Oh, I was wondering what that is. But basically, just a lot of cool stuff on how this all works and just how, how to interact with everything. And also, how to possibly someday use totemic as a way to generate power, which could be very cool, but for now, not yet. So, yeah. I also made these fences right here. This looks quite a bit nicer, in my opinion, than, what I used to have. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. So, first thing what I want to have is a system to pretty much, generate the power or charge or whatever I should call it into this chlorophyll crystal. And for that, it shouldn't be an extremely difficult thing to do. Pretty much all I need to set up is a farm of some sort to, fill this thing up. So, what I was thinking is we got a very cool mod called Random Things. And this mod is pretty awesome. I suggested it ages ago, but it didn't get added then. But it is added now, so that's pretty cool. And pretty much the one thing that I really like that this mod adds is fertilized dirt. This thing is rather expensive looking at the cost of rotten flesh and the bone meal. But basically these things make it so that the crops around it grow 3 times their normal speed. They don't require water nearby. And you can't even trample the crops when jumping on them. So that's actually pretty awesome, and of course when used for this totem of raining, pretty amazing. So let me see if I can find someone that has a lot of rotten flesh or maybe something like a zombie and skeleton farm, and then I'll be right back. Okay, apparently Poppycox has himself a nice little cursed earth farm, basically got himself tons of bones and rotten flesh, so I borrowed some of his. Thanks, Poppycox, if you're watching. So, yeah, let me quickly get some of this stuff going. Let's see. Maybe it will be faster if I do it in this thingy. This goes there. Then this. What's the pattern again? Wait, can I do it like this? Oh. I guess it doesn't allow you to. That's too bad. But I can do this. Then I need some more bones. That's one stack. And then I can take the dirt out of here. Then do this again. Don't lag. I hate lag. Okay, I'm definitely lagging. Okay, I don't know why I just crashed, but I now got myself 2 stacks of fertilized dirt. Awesome. And now I can quickly put all this other stuff away, because I don't need all of this in my bags. And something is bugged. Oh well. So, now all I need to do is find myself, first of all, a nice spot where I can put this little setup. It doesn't have to be too far from my base. Like, maybe right here should be enough. And I should really also put in something against the rain. Just because I can. Let me just disable it for now. Just for the purpose of recording. Because it's annoying as hell when I'm recording and rain's everywhere. So, let's see. First of all, I need to clear off a little bit of an area for this thing to set up. I guess I can simply suffice with a 9x9 setup. Should be easy enough. So yeah, let me quickly break this thingy. And... wow. This thing just looks like a freaking crystal from Sims. Cool though. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And then 9 to this direction. Quickly need to clear out this thingy so I can place the fancy fertilized dirt out. And let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then also I will be, well, hopefully not too difficult to actually automate this entire process. But we'll see in just a minute or so. Okay, let's see. Nice. Awesome. And, wait. Huh? Oh. Oops. Messed up. That's why it didn't look too nice. As you can see, even when I jump as high as I can again, yeah, it's not doing anything special. Which is cool, actually, because that's just what I needed to. So now what I can do is put this thingy in here. Then the, well, I only need one totem structure, I guess, now. So now what I can do is put this chlorophyll crystal in here. Totem of draining in there. And now I need to get myself a bunch of seeds. So let's see. Nature stuff. Well, I don't have too many seeds. Oh well. Don't really matter for now. Eventually I will get a bit more. Nice. And nice. What I should actually do is quickly dig it out and use my watering can to grow these things just a little bit more. And it's night time. Well, that doesn't really help. And potion ivy somewhere. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Potion ivy. Man, I hate that stuff. Let me quickly sleep through the night and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. A nice little field full of seeds. So, as you guys can already see happening is, well, I can speed it up with this thingy. The crops will grow. And right at that same moment, like you see right there, the Stoning of Dreading will take out the, well, pretty much the life essence, make it downgrade one few stages, and then it will put the charge onto this chlorophyll crystal. Currently we got 539, essence in this thingy, and when I do a little bit of this magic, just for a little second. You can see it's now at 550. And that's pretty cool. So, this is actually very cool and all, but in no way useful yet. If I look up in the Totemic mod, item.totempedia.name. Ah, cool. But we got some very cool, pretty much upgrades, sort of things, like modules, I should say. Pretty much this one gives you speed, collects items, doesn't do yet, gives you the rain puts it away, burn like a blaze, I have no idea what this, maybe putting you on fire, no idea what that should be helpful though, but oh well. Fear creepers, breathe on the water. Feed players. Oh, feed players. Huh, that's actually a pretty nice one to have around my base. And bring love to nearby animals. So, that's already the last two, pretty much two things that I really like. Just imagine right here having a totem to make these animals love each other. And right in the center of this thingy, nice place again, simply put the one that's feeding you and possibly even the speed buff or, you know, anything else that I can put here, and have this farm charging all my crystals for me, or even maybe make a second farm of this stuff someday. But yeah, I think that would be pretty cool. So now all I need to try out is actually if this thing works with pipes. And I have not tried it yet, and hopefully I won't crash the server doing this stuff. But it could be actually pretty cool if it does work, because, well, if it does, then I can get some very cool stuff going. So let's quickly try this out, and if it does, then I will be very satisfied. So let's see, what I could do is simply break underneath this thing. set up a chest right there. Then some pipes. And it does connect. Well, guess that's a good thing. Then put this thing to output mode. Put this thingy. Then put it to on. And let's see. If I put this thingy in here, will it be put into this thing? Ah, I guess it does. Awesome. So it's at 583 right now. And let's see if this actually works now. So let's see. Quickly grow it a little bit more. Of course, it's nighttime again. Then they won't grow at all. I should really put some lighting out here. But yeah, as you can see, it is actually growing. So let me quickly get some other stuff ready. Then I'll also probably fence off this area just a little bit and put some light sources out here so these things will even grow during the night. And I'll be right back. Okay, so this crystal seemed to finally completely recharge. So that's just what I wanted to have. For the purpose of what I can do now is... let's see, I can put it to this thingy and say blacklist any charged ones. And in this thingy, what I can do is, I need a little bit more space. Can I? Nope, I guess I need some covers. Do I have a saw? Ah, yes I do. Nice. Quickly get myself a few of those covers going so I can make this all work the way I wanted it to. Or at least, I hope this will work the way I wanted it to. Like that, and that. Then put a pneumatic servo in this thingy. And say, only take out a completely charged one. And make it always active. And there we go. So, what should happen, if I place this thing in here, nothing should happen. Nice. I should make it ignore MBT, use MBT to use the data on this thingy, which is, I think, a bit important for this. So it still shouldn't do anything though. Nice. But if I quickly break this and put this thing in there, it will be taken out. Awesome. And a little bug that makes this thing have a lot of these at the same time. But this is pretty cool. Why, you might ask? Well, what I could do now is replace this thing with an ender chest. Simply craft myself a few more of those crystals. And every time, if I want to, I could, for example, have one totem right sitting right here to have a special effect or something. And hook that up to the same ender chest. And then pretty much what will happen is every time, it will be placed in here. And if I configure it on that side, then if to take the crystal out, if it has been completely discharged, then put it back into the ender chest, this thing will charge it up again, and I'll probably have a few buffer energy crystals, so these things will be always running, and this thing will be, well, working just the way I wanted it to. And I think that should be pretty awesome, at least I hope it will be. So, yeah, let me quickly get myself some ender chest going, and some more crystals. They take, well, not too long, but are quite an annoying thing to craft. So, like this. All these bottles and such. So, let me quickly do that, and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. Two ender chests and three stacks of bottles of chlorophyll. And now I quickly need to turn them into these diamond thingies. Oh, and also I really need to show you guys something. My, this farm, like I said, wasn't even done yet running last time. Well, it is running now, and man, almost a stack of redstone, a stack of coal, stack of this stuff, almost a stack of that stuff. This filled up with over two stacks of diamonds and more stuff. This is almost half full of iron, and this thing has some iron in it. I mean, man, this thingy, overpowered. Nice though, but overpowered. And I like overpowered. Oh well, let's see. Get these crystals going. Nice. So now what I should be able to do is, if I get back to here. And let's say right there. Break this for a minute. Put one ender chest in here. And don't need to rotate it. What I can do is put this in there. Nothing should happen. Put this in there. And it's taking out. Awesome. And this thing should automatically... Oh, wow. That drained the stingy quickly. Ha, nice. Just what I wanted to see happen. So now what I should be able to do is simply, you know, put all this stuff in here. And this thing will recharge sooner or later. Awesome. Wow. This is very cool. So now for the second thing that I want. I believe that if I look up Totemic again... first of all, we got the Brains of Love, and I don't really need that right now, but I definitely will. And then we got the Feed Nearby Players. This is the one that I think I currently want to have. So I believe it feeds you when you are below three of those thingies. So let's see, I need one of these and one of these. Then I need my infused totemic stuff. Did I put my... No, I thought I put it in there. I do have this thingy right here, so let's see. The horse one, hopper, bat, sun, blaze, ocelot, underwater breeding, and feeding. Also, I really think that Pokefans should nerf these recipes up just a little bit, because these things are quite easy to craft, actually. And, you know, it's just rather expensive. So, let's see. One's intelligence structure. And one of these thingies. Then what I can do is set up a pretty much the same system as I had right there. Just a little bit smaller. And I need two servos. And I'm not gonna eat yet. See if how much it will regenerate in a minute. Two servos. Let's see if this actually works out the way I wanted it to work. And if so, then I'm a happy man. Okay, so this can go there, this can go there. Then let's say, take it out once it is completely drained out. And make it whitelist. And this thingy only take out full ones. Which is this one. So let's see. Take it out, whitelist, only this one. So, it's taking it out. And it placed it in this thingy. So now what I can do, if I put this thing on, it should feed me when I get below, I believe it's 3 food bars. So let me quickly just run around a bit, see if I can get my food to go down, maybe even get hunger. Do I, wait, yeah, I forgot that I did have some rotten flesh in my base. But let's see if this will do anything. I'm at 3 and a bit right now. And nothing yet. Please say this does work. Otherwise, I'll be sad. It is in there, right? Oh. Lagging. Is it in there? Yes, it is. Why isn't it doing anything? Well, I believe it was 3 hunger. I'm not exactly sure. I'll check up on that in just a minute. And if not, then I'll need to send this to Pokefan. Because, well, it's broken. I think. Pokefan, work. Go back to coding. Oh well. For now, this is a nice little setup just for this thingy working. And this thing should also be working just fine. If I quickly look in this thing. Yes, it is. Nice. And this thing should now be backlogged. Ah, yes it is. Huh, cool. Cool, cool. So, yeah. Let me quickly get going on what I want to do for the second part of the episode. And I'll be right back. Okay, guys. So, for the second part of the episode, I wanted to get started with an awesome mod which could be called overpowered, and you guys all know it. It's Dartcraft. Simply because, well, I'm not gonna use too much of the Dartcraft stuff, like, anytime soon. But some things are really awesome just to have in general, and I definitely want to get into that. So, I don't think too much stuff has actually changed in Dartcraft between, well, what I should consider right now and the previous Let's Play that I had. So, yeah, let's just get started. So first of all, I need a Force Sapling, which is created with a Force Rod and on a Sapling. So I need a Force Ingot, and I might as well get myself a bunch of this stuff, because I'm rich. Well, rich considering ores, so that's awesome. And I need one of these thingies. And then I need a normal stick, not this infused one. And I need, let's see. So what I should be able to do is do this, this, and this, and get myself a 2 durability Force Rod. You might guess, if you're new to Force Dartcraft, wait, why do you get one with that low durability? Well, I will show you. What I can do is right click on the sapling. Ta-da! One magical Force Slapping. And now all I need to do is grow fast, so hopefully this watering can will do the job. Otherwise, I need to check if it works with bone meal. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Then I can quickly chop this puppy down. And luckily we got an incredibly fast, sapling decay rate, or a leaf decay rate, so that's just awesome. But the thing that I now need, or got, is these logs. And these logs are just nice. Basically these things are, well, the main thing that are necessary in Dartcraft, but mainly it allows you to create force sticks, which is cool. So now what I can do is do this, this, and this. And I got myself a full durability Force Rod, and no longer need this thingy. Awesome. So now what I need is a Force Infuser. And basically you create this by right clicking with the Force Rod onto an infusing, or into an enchanting table. So let me quickly get an enchanting table going. I need 2 diamonds and a book. And I of course got that going already. So let's see, this, this. Then I should be able to, I think, also do this. Yeah, nice. And this thing does require power, so redstone energy conduits. I should really expand this room sooner or later, so I can probably also put some other stuff like right there, because this is getting way too crowded. Let me get rid of these things. It's not like I will need them anyway anytime soon. And put this thingy down. And oh, that filled up quickly. Then this thing also requires liquid force, so ta-da. And then what I need to do is get myself another book. And plunk it on the ground. And by the power of force, I got myself an upgrade tome with, well, it says tier 1, 0 force, and I'm the owner. Awesome. So now what I can do is put this thingy in there, look up the info, and see all the things that I need to do to advance to a next level. So first of all, it appears to be a small fragment of forest. Perhaps I could use it to modify a sword. Well, I know what it is, so that's easy enough. What I can do is get myself a force sword. Put this thingy in there. Put a force nugget on there. It will be enchanting. And I've got myself a knockback 1 sword. And this thing will give me more detailed info once you actually tried it out. Which is cool. This thing, also pretty cool. They say the bats hold a secret to increase damage. Well, I also know what this thingy is. So what I can do is put this thingy away. Get myself a bat claw. Get myself another sword going. Just so I can get to a further stage, which has something I really want. And what is this thing? Tastes like win and diabetes. That sounds mean. let's see, can I also put the sugar that I need? Sorry if these are a bit spoilers for you guys. But I used to be a Dartcraft, well, I could say Dartcraft beta tester, sort of. So yeah, I know Dartcraft pretty well. Let's see, can I do this? No, I cannot. Well, I still know what I can do with it, so. Ta-da, 1 damage. And now what I can do is get a X and get the other two upgrades, which are Force Lock and Sugar. And this will unlock the second two. Oh, and by the way, this is this upgrade serves boost. It can put on swords and punch when punched or put on bows. So that's cool. And now I am a tier 2. So now, as you can see, I unlocked all these two thingies. Awesome. And it's also some very cool things that I can do now. So let's see what stuff I need. I don't exactly remember all of it. Lapis, fortune, upgrade, flint, and an enchanting thingy. That's easy enough done. So one of these, piece of flint. What else was it again? A upgrade. So I can instantly get to the second tier. And then I think I will have to wrap up the episode. So let's see. Piece of lapis. Already had that. No, I do not. I thought I did. Piece of lapis. A fortune. Let me quickly look that up. Because I can't remember the recipe out of my head. A cookie and a piece of paper. And do I happen to have cookies from random loot or anything? Food. Oh, nice, I do. And some paper, which I apparently do not have on me. And eat this thingy. And give me one fortune. And then the final thing that I will need is a force pack upgrade. Force upgrade. Let's see, force. If I remember, force pack upgrade. I need 4 pieces of wool and 4 pieces of leather. And I'm already low on resources that have to do with natural stuff. So that's also something I should make soon. Then I will also need myself a forest backpack to use this thing on. So that's for more leather. And I believe I can smelt rotten flesh to get leather. Dried flesh. That's not what I needed. Oh wait, it is creating leather. Huh, nice. The best is just a redstone furnace recipe. I ain't complaining. That's awesome. Then what I need is a chest. Nice. Ta-da. So now I can infuse all this stuff. That's one. A force pack. Now I need the fortune and this thingy. So I believe that both go on a pickaxe. Let me see if this is actually possible to put both of them on. This, this, and this. Yes, it is. Then I need a force shears and a book. So let's see, one book. And this thingy. And it's almost done. Nice. Then a book and a bottle. Enchanting. Nice. And there is something that I recently tested out, which is, well, if I would call it one of the most overpowered items there are in this game. But it's so awesome, you know. And I can't wait to show you guys it. And am I tier 2 right? Yes, I am. I believe I can put it a perfect timepiece. Yes, I can. Oh, God. You guys won't believe what this thingy is that I'm currently looking at. Pretty much what I need is a force torch. So how do I get that thingy? Black force torch. See if there's any recipe. Oh. Golden power source and a force stick. And a golden power source is simply a furnace smelted piece of Darkcraft log. So that's, well, not too insane, even though the name sounds pretty crazy. And now what I can do is, for the perfect timepiece, which I happen to know what it is I need Well, I might as well make 6 of them. So that's 1, 2, 3, 6, 12, 24. I need 24 of this. Don't lag on me. And I can put this stuff away. Then I also need 6 pieces of redstone. And once I show you guys what this thingy is, well, let's just say you will agree when I say this is the most overpowered item there is. The time torch. Yes. Get 6 of those. This thingy pretty much... Well, I don't even know why Blue Dart came up with this thingy. This thing can be so incredibly overpowered, but also pretty awesome at the same time. Why? Huh, bug found. This thing should show up, not the other one. Oh well. So, let's just go to right here. What I can do is place the time torch somewhere. Let me quickly get a platform to place this thingy on. Let's say right there. Put this thingy down. On its own, it will slowly, you know, speed up the growth of these thingies. But this thingy has a configuration option. Slow, fast, or hyper mode. Now, these things will grow in hyperspeed, as you guys can see right here. I mean, dude, Blue Dart, why did you think this is not overpowered? Look at this. This puppy will charge up these thingies like a beast. I mean, let's see, halfway, or 481 it was at. And just look up in just a second again. You know, just wait one little minute. Now it's at 600. Oh god, I love abusing mods. Is this thing also getting speed up by this thingy? It's not... Wait, what? Water, zero heat, brine's full. Why is it incomplete? Complete, yes. It's not getting any faster, it seems like. And what happens if I put one of these torches right here? Is it creating... Huh. I believe it's actually even creating more brine for me. Wow. Guys, I'm definitely gonna leave this torch here. If you guys think this is way too overpowered, just let me know. You know, I will take it down, but just for now, I think this is pretty awesome. I mean, I can even simply, like, put it there. Break all of this. And... It's so overpowered that these things are glitching up right here. That's... a bug. Entity Dotcraft, Entity Frozen... Well... Yeah, I have to do something about that. Strange bug though that I found. Awesome. Wow, I think I definitely broke something. Oh well, I guess it would be a good wrapping up point for this episode, guys. So, thanks for watching. Please leave a rating. Let me know what you think about all this overpowered awesomeness. And I'll hope to see you guys all next time.